Hello, I'm Dr. Gillian Murtagh, a medical director here at Abbott. I'm a trained cardiologist and I'm here to answer cardiovascular questions sent in by members of the Abbott HeartMates community. Let's have a heart to heart. All right, let's dive into the HeartMates inbox. Kate from Nebraska asks, how does pregnancy impact a woman's heart? That's a great question, Kate. Pregnancy can make the heart work quite a bit harder. The blood volume in the circulation goes up about 30 to 50%. The blood vessels dilate and the heart rate increases. Sometimes heart or cardiovascular conditions that the patient had before pregnancy can become more pronounced. And sometimes cardiovascular conditions can be uncovered by pregnancy. Women become more short of breath and fatigued and can develop leg swelling during normal pregnancy, but it is important to watch for increasing or overwhelming shortness of breath, leg swelling, severe headaches, visual problems, and chest or belly pain, among other symptoms. So talk to your doctor and know your risk and steps to minimize your risk of heart problems before, during, and after pregnancy. Alicia from New York asks, is there research being done to address the polypharmaceutical nature of heart failure treatment? So thank you, Alicia, for the question. And by polypharmacy, we usually mean regular use of five or more medications at the same time. That often happens in heart failure as guidelines suggest several medications are effective. There are four pillars of treatment often mentioned, meaning four classes of medication. But that is tough for people with heart failure to take all those tablets. So studies are ongoing to combine several drugs like blood pressure medications used to treat heart failure and diuretics into one pill. But these are not yet available for routine use in the USA. So ask your doctor for more information. Okay, and up next we have Daniel from Colorado who wants to know, how important is blood pressure cuff placement when checking blood pressure at home? Hi, Daniel. It is important. The cuff should be at heart level. You should be relaxed and it should cover about 80% of your arm. But you should check the instructions that come with your own cuff, as there are many types out there now. It's important to have it on bare skin. It's important that it's the right size, because if it's too big, it can make your blood pressure appear lower than it is, and vice versa. Let's go back to the inbox. We have Seth from Maryland who asks, which foods do you recommend and which do you suggest avoiding for maintaining a healthy heart? Well, some people are on specific diets for medical reasons or have allergies, but in general, it's best if we limit the number of processed foods that you eat. It's best to avoid or limit sodium from common foods that add the most sodium to your diet, like burgers, tacos, and pizza. And it's good to eat more fresh foods like fruits and vegetables, lean meats, fish, seafood, and plant-based proteins. We always want to read the food labels and avoid items that are high in saturated fats, sodium, and added sugars. So it's great to plan ahead and prepare healthy snacks and meals at home made from whole fresh foods. Okay, who else has questions? Let's check it out. So Greg from California asks, are there any studies being performed for alternative anticoagulants to warfarin for mechanical valve patients? And that's a really interesting question. And warfarin acts against vitamin K to keep blood flowing smoothly. We call it an anticoagulant, as you say. It was discovered because cows who ate spoiled clover had a lot of bleeding. And it does work great to do its job, but it does come with the need to get regular blood tests for your INR, or international normalization ratio, which measures how thin your blood is, basically. And it does have a lot of interactions with foods and other medications, so it's quite a burden for patients. However, the newer class of drugs like direct anticoagulants or DOACs that don't carry that requirement for INR checks are not yet recommended in guidelines for mechanical valve patients as of fall of 2024. But research is ongoing, so ask your doctor to keep you informed. Wow, these are really important questions. I love this, guys. Keep them coming. So let's see what we've got. We have Chad from Arkansas who asks, I've heard that cancer can be associated with heart problems. Is that true? Yes, Chad, that is a really great question. Cancer and heart disease share many of the same risk factors like smoking, and cancer treatments have greatly increased survival for many types of cancers. But it is important to know that certain cancer treatments can be associated with an increased risk for things like heart failure. There's now, in fact, a whole specialty called cardio-oncology for that reason, to ensure that people have the best possible cancer treatment while minimizing heart problems. So if you, Chad, are being treated, or you are a survivor, or anyone in the audience, talk to your doctor to make sure you understand what your risk is and what steps you can take to reduce that risk. Those are all the questions we will have time for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something valuable. If you'd like information on how to become a member of the Abbott HeartMates community, please visit abbott.com/heartmates. See you next time.